Right now, 100 million radiation-blasted, flesh-eating flies are raining down over the jungles of Panama to commit a genocide that can never end. Their tiny bodies are rebuilding a wall of flesh that protects an entire continent. This is one of humanity's most successful wars, going on for over 50 years now, fought from Central America to the deserts of Libya. Okay, so what's going on? The unbeatable flesh-eating fly. We need to talk about one of the most terrifying parasites on Earth for a moment. Don't worry, we won't make it too gross. If you want to skip this part, jump to the next chapter. Cochlea maya hominivorax, which literally means the man-eater. The New World screwworm fly at home in the Americas. Each of these metallic blue-green flies with bright red eyes that exist in nature is here because it's feasted on the flesh of a warm-blooded animal. Cochlea maya can detect wounds and smell blood across vast distances. If a human, a deer, or a squirrel has the tiniest scratch, female screwworm flies will try to lay eggs in the wound. When they hatch, the worms start eating healthy flesh with sharp mandibles, causing horrible wounds, attracting even more flies. In serious cases, the animal will die, or at least be severely weakened. Cochlea maya doesn't add anything positive to the world and is a natural enemy of ours. For most of history, this parasite was simply a horrifying fact of life in the Americas. And then, we accidentally created a paradise for them. As farmers introduced millions and millions of cows to the vast expanses of the southern US, screwworms became a catastrophic problem and a source of endless suffering for our defenseless cattle. One outbreak might wipe out herds and lead to cruel, lingering deaths for countless animals in the wild. Traditional pesticides were useless against cochlea maya because you couldn't poison something that lived inside a living animal's flesh. You couldn't prevent animals from getting injured or flies from finding wounds. The situation seemed hopeless, and cochlea maya was winning. Ranchers had to spend countless hours examining their herds, treating wounds, trying to protect newborns, watching helplessly as their animals suffered. And then two scientists in the 1950s had an idea that was too wild to be taken seriously at first. What if we kind of nuke the screwworms? Radioactive parasite factories. Screwworm flies have a major weakness. Female cochlea maya can lay up to 400 eggs multiple times. But they only mate a single time before they die at the ripe old age of 3 weeks. So what if we could somehow disrupt the mating process? What if we could flood the environment with sterile male flies? The females would waste their one and only chance at reproduction on males that couldn't produce offspring. An entire species could theoretically mate itself out of existence. But how do you sterilize millions of flies without killing them or making them too weak to compete for mates? Well, it turned out the timing to do this was kind of perfect. Scientists studying the effects of radiation had discovered that specific doses could damage reproductive cells while leaving the rest of an organism intact. So all we needed to do was figure out how high this dose was for cochlea maya, breed millions of flies, irradiate them, and release them over thousands of square kilometers. Imagine explaining this idea to someone in 1950. Imagine the scale of the damage and the suffering that cochlea maya caused for people to say, okay, sure, let's try this, why not? To prove this could work, scientists built a screwworm paradise in Florida and shipped millions of flies to the remote island of Curaçao. Long trays were filled with ground beef and horse meat, animal blood, milk and eggs. Thousands were bred, irradiated, and released into the wild in regular intervals. As the weeks and months passed, more and more of the cochlea maya on the island were infertile and mated with regular ones. First slowly, and then suddenly, they were no more. Completely eradicated. It was time to think much bigger. Over the next few decades, a war was declared and professional worm factories established to breed them by the billions. A single plant in Texas alone needed 70 tons of meat and 12,000 gallons of blood to breed 150 million flies per week. The disgusting mix had to be kept warm because they had to believe they were inside a living animal. This lovely process made the insects smell so bad that airlines initially refused to transport them. Their transport boxes had to be sprayed with cologne just to get them on planes. Bit by bit, in a slow-moving wave of biological warfare, the program eradicated screwworms. first from Florida, then across Texas, through Mexico, and into Central America. Every step required billions of sterile flies, massive coordination, and unwavering dedication from thousands of workers. It was an incredible victory of humanity over the horrors of nature. In 1988, the war suddenly became global, and for the first time ever, screwworms escaped to Africa. The stakes were astronomical. If not stopped immediately, flesh-eating Cochlearmya could move down the Nile Valley, around the North African coast, and conquer regions where medical care was scarce or non-existent. The potential suffering was incalculable. To stop this invasion, a Herculean operation was triggered immediately. Hundreds of millions of sterile flies were flown in. Ground teams inspected millions of animals for wounds. Communication campaigns explained to locals why planes were dropping boxes full of millions of flesh-eating American flies. But it worked. In just 4 months, the invasion was stopped. But Cochlearmya still held a firm grip over the Amazon rainforest and much of South America. An area too large, politically complicated, and expensive to expand the war further. So a deal was made with Panama, the narrowest part of the continent. The US and Mexico would pay for a wall of flesh in the small country. It would prevent any screwworms from reaching the north ever again. Today, deep in Panama, a nuclear worm factory runs 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, producing an endless stream of sterile flies. The technology has come a long way from the early days. Instead of ground meat, a brown protein sludge made from powdered blood, milk, and eggs is piped into trays stacked in rooms kept at exactly the same temperature as living tissue. Thousands of flies are then carefully irradiated with precise doses of radiation, creating Cochlearmya that acts normal but are dead inside. Each week, 100 million flies are loaded into rotating dispersal machines to be released mid-flight in a finely tuned balance of drop rate, speed, and altitude. The flight paths are separated by precisely 1.6 kilometers in a choreographed aerial ballet, creating an invisible wall of sterile flies. Surveillance teams cover some of the most remote and challenging terrain to check animals for injuries and monitor for any sign of screwworm activity. Unfortunately, right now, the wall is failing and the war against Cochlearmya is far from over. Cochlearmya strikes back. In 2016, Cochlearmya somehow made their way back to the Florida Keys, turning the Paradise Islands into a nightmare. Key deer were suddenly walking around with gaping wounds. Millions of sterile flies were rushed in from Panama, creating a front around the outbreak and beginning the eradication again. Within months, the invasion was at least contained. And in late 2023, the wall in Panama failed and Cochlearmya struck back immediately. Like a parasitic firestorm on speed, it spread again all over Panama and Costa Rica, burning through Central America and even reaching Mexico. The worm factory now produces sterile worms at maximum capacity. It's a real biological emergency, and it's not clear when it will be over. One day, we might be able to win the war against this horrible monster. We did so before, and other parasites have been eradicated from much of the world or even entirely. So if you find yourself in Central America and see a low-flying plane overhead, maybe you're witnessing another day in one of humanity's most unusual wars. A war we can never stop fighting and can't afford to lose. Incredible breakthroughs often start with ideas that sound incredibly crazy at first. Seeing solutions where others see dead ends isn't a rare skill only geniuses are born with. It's one you can start building right now in just minutes a day with the help of our friends at Brilliant. Brilliant will make you smarter every day with thousands of interactive, bite-sized lessons that transform your mind into a problem-solving machine. On Brilliant, learning feels more like playing a game. You'll get hands-on with big ideas in everything from maths and science to AI, data analysis, and beyond. You'll not only gain knowledge of key concepts, you'll learn to apply them to real-world situations. Brilliant is constantly releasing new and updated lessons, so you'll never run out of fascinating topics to explore. Spending just a few minutes a day, you'll quickly become a smarter thinker and problem solver with all the tools you need to make breakthroughs of your own. To start exploring everything Brilliant has to offer for free for a full 30 days, visit brilliant.org/nutshell or click on the link in the description. You'll also get 20% off an annual premium subscription. This bird has magical powers. Let's see a demonstration. Bring in the latest scientific research. Wow, that's a lot of complicated stuff about the immune system and all its cells. How could someone possibly understand all of this? Incredible! This overview is delightful and easy to grasp, but still scientifically accurate. Let's make it a bit more difficult. Can she make all of evolution visible at a glance? This is brilliant. You can clearly see the relationships between species and how they evolved. And look at those illustrations. These posters are ready to be shared with the world. These very special pieces of Kurzgesagt are now available on our shop along with many other sciencey products, all researched with care and created with love by the Burbs with Magical Powers. Every Kurzgesagt product you buy directly funds another moment we get to spend working on our videos. Thank you so much for being a part of our story and for making this channel possible.